Namaste. Today we are going to learn about arithmetic progression. We can call arithmetic progression as AP. And this AP is a sequence. Do you know what is a sequence? A sequence is set of related events or numbers or any items that follow each other in a particular order. There is a particular order for each sequence. If we are considering multiples of 2. Here this is a sequence and there is a particular order followed by each number. That is, each number is increasing by 2. Here 2. 2 plus 2 is 4. 4 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8. Now consider another sequence. Like this. This is also a sequence because it have a particular order. Each is less by 1. The numbers are followed by difference of 1. So these are different types of sequence. And now we are going to talk about arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is a list of number or sequence of number in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number. There is a fixed number added to each term and that sequence is called as AP or arithmetic progression. Let us check some of the arithmetic progressions. Check these patterns. These are all sequences. There is a particular order followed by each number. Also, this is AP because it has a fixed number added to following numbers from previous numbers. Let us check here. 1 plus 1 is 2. Now this is the fixed number here. And 2 plus that fixed number, 3. You got the next number. Now 3 plus that fixed number. Fixed number is here 1. So 3 plus 1 is 4. Now the next number will be 4 plus 1, 5. So here we can see a fixed number. What about this set? Here also fixed number is 5. Each number varies by 5. Here fixed number is 3. So this fixed number between each numbers in an arithmetic progression is called common difference. Also, it can be a positive value, 0, or a negative value. If this is an arithmetic progression, we can say in this arithmetic progression, the common difference is 0. So with each number we are adding that fixed number or common difference 0 to get the very next number. So common difference can be positives, 0 or negatives. Now what about each numbers in an arithmetic progression? They have a particular name and that is term. Each number in an arithmetic progression is called as term. And this will be the first term. If an arithmetic progression is infinite, then we can't see the last term. But if it is finite arithmetic progression, then we can say there is a last term. If it was like this, that is, it is not an infinite one, we can say this is the last term and this is the first term. But in this case, this is infinite arithmetic progression, so we cannot say what is the last term, but we can say this is the first term. So we have finite arithmetic progression, that is they end at a particular term, and we have a last term in that arithmetic progression. And if it is infinite, we can say they will never end at a particular term, it will continue. So it has no last term, but in both cases we have first term. Now let us check what is a general form of an AP. So here I will write A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, etc. Here D is the common difference and A is the first term. Let us check in an arithmetic progression whether this is true or not. We will consider 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, etc. This is an example of AP. Now A is the first term. So this is the first term. So here A equal to 2. Now, next, in general, we can say a plus d, that is first term plus d. Difference, what is the difference here? To find the common difference, you have to take any two consecutive terms from an AP. Here, let us take these two terms, consecutive terms. Now, you have to subtract the preceding term from this, that is 6 minus 4. Difference is 2. So, here d is also 2. Let us consider another example. Here it will be slight confused because a is 2, d is also 2. We will take another d. 1, 3, 5. So, let us consider this one. Here a is 1, d will be. Take any two consecutive terms. Let us take these two. And in those two terms, subtract the first number from the preceding number. So, here it will be 7 minus 5, it is 2. So, d is here 2, a is 1. Now, let us check this with general form of AP. So, a is 1. Yes, 1. Let us check whether we will get this sequence after substituting values for this. Next, a is again 1 plus d is 2. 1 plus 2, 3. Yes, we got the second term. Now, a is 1, 1 plus 2 into 2, 2 2s are 4, 4 plus 1, 5. Yes, we got the third term, and this is 1 plus 3 into common difference is 2, 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7. Yes, so this is the general form of AP. A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, A plus 4D. Actually, simply D means A plus 1D. Difference into 1. Here, difference into 2 plus first term. Here, difference into 3 plus first term. Next will be difference into 4 plus first term. Next term is difference into 5 plus first term. Now, check this is an AP. Here, this is first term. Let us name it as A1, this is A2, this is A3, A4, A5, A6 and A7. We know this is A, that is first term, this will be A plus D, where D is the common difference. This will be A plus 2D, this is A plus 3D, like that. So, to get fourth term, what you have to do? A4, fourth term, you have to A means A1, okay, A1 plus D, A1 plus 2D, A1 plus 3D. To get the fourth term, that is A4, what you have to do is A1 plus 3D, okay. Now, there is an equation forming from this, A4 equal to A1 plus 3, we can connect with this 4 and write it as 4 minus 1 into D, okay. This is fourth term. Now, what about fifth term? Fifth term, that is A5 equal to A5. Here, A1 plus D, A1 plus 2D, A1 plus 3D. This will be A1 plus 4D. That is A5 is fifth term. And to get that fifth term, you will write A1 plus 4D. Now, connecting with this 5 and 4, we can rewrite it as A5 equal to A1 plus 4 can be written as 5 minus 1 into D. So, from this we can generalize it. That is, if we don't know the term, that is AN, the N can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 or any number. We don't know which term is this. So, we are simply writing it as nth term, AN. Then we can say, from all this, you can see first comes the first term in the AP. So, it is the A1. If it is A4, A1 is the. If it is A5, A1 is the. If it is AN also, A1 will be the. No change in that. Now, next up, plus, to get fourth term, you are subtracting 4 minus 1. To get fifth term, you are subtracting 5 minus 1 here. So, to get nth term, what you have to do here will be n minus 1. So, this is the general form of AP or nth term of AP. If we don't know a particular term, then to find it, you have to know the first term, also the difference. Then we can find out what will be the number in that particular term. If the seventh term is missing here, if it was not here, this is the seventh term, if it was missing, and if we are asked to find the seventh term, what will you say? This becomes A7. This is A7, and here it is first term. What is the first term here? 1 plus, this is A7, so this becomes 7 minus 1. 7 minus 1 is 6 into difference. Here, what is the difference? To find the difference, subtract 2 consecutive number. That is 5 minus 3, 2. So, 6 2s. So, 1 plus here, 6 2s are 12. 12 plus 1, 13 is the 7th term. If we don't know the 8th term, it becomes like this. 8 equal to 1 plus 8 minus 1. If 8th term is missing, we can say 8 minus 1 into D. That is 7D. D is here again 2. So we will say 1 plus 7, 2s are 14. So 1 plus 14 is 15. So this is how we find out the term, missing term in an AP. The general form is An equal to A1 plus N minus 1 into D. Here N is the missing term. A1 means first term. D is the common difference. Now also, here, if a step is like this, you want to consider Bode-Mas rule. Okay? Bode-Mas. Otherwise, the answer will be wrong. So here, we have an addition. Here, we have multiplication. So in this Bode-Mas, multiplication comes first, then only addition. So first, find the product here. Then only you can add this one. Then you will get the correct answer. If you are doing like this, 1 plus 6 into 2, 1 plus 6, 7. 7 2s are 14. It is not correct. It is the wrong answer. So always think about Bode-Mas. If a step comes like this, first do the multiplication, then add the numbers. Then you will get the exact term. So these are the very basics of AP. We can learn it in detail in the coming videos. That is, we can do exercise questions. Thank you.